Good morning from a chilly PE. There is a storm raging outside today. It's been going on for the last few days. And apparently it's still going to be going on for a few more days of wind, chill, rain. And you know, here in PE, we are not used to this level of cold. The wind, yes, but this level of cold is something else. Last night I thought the roof was going to come off. The sliding door was rattling around like a thing possessed. And the driving rain against the window was enough for me to get up and go and check what was going on. Through my limited view of the window there, the trees were flopping around like people at a rave, high on ecstasy, and there was a gate creaking somewhere in the distance there, banging. I don't know if it was on my property or somewhere else. I thought I was going to see cars lying on their sides and walls washed over, but everything seemed to be holding their ground. It was difficult to sleep though. Just as I thought the storm was passing, another gust would come up again and everything would start rattling and flopping around again. It was very disconcerting. I lay there wondering what the worst was that could possibly happen and what I could do about it if the roof did actually blow off. Very little it seems. That storm was way bigger than me. So as I was lying there awake in the dark, willing the storm to pass, I thought that this is what the lockdown and the coronavirus is doing to us. The coronavirus is not like a storm, no, it's more like a sleuth, covert and undercover, insinuating tentacles we can't imagine, with only the lockdown rules and people in hospital and all the deaths to account for it. This unseen enemy has crept into our lives, our psyches, until there was very little else that we could talk about, think about, read about, hear about. Everywhere we turned, people were discussing coronavirus and the impact that it was having. But now, only now, the actual storm is beginning. The damage that we will be able to see, other than those who have died from the coronavirus, the broken economy like flapping trees, the closed businesses like that banging sliding door, and us lying there in the dark, wondering what the hell we can do about it, feeling so helpless. Yeah, only now the devastation will become apparent. And lying there in the dark, helpless, we come to the realization that the storm is not out there. The storm is in here. If we don't come to realize and fix what is happening in here, then there is nothing we can do about the damage out there. We will not be ready to fix it. It's not for nothing that flight attendants tells you that you have to put on your own mask before you see to somebody else, even those nearest and dearest to you, because you have no use to anybody if you are not alive, if you are not well. You first have to look after yourself. So I guess what I'm saying is don't celebrate the freedoms that have come with the new purchase freedom, new purchase power. Rather be vigilant to the havoc that this state of disaster has caused, the tiredness, the poor health, the inability to socialize that has created weariness, the increased crime and unsafe communities, the danger to our children stranded at home, the women folk that are bearing the brunt of the poor cash flow, the frustration of men at home, the wave of buried racial resentment that the lockdown has brought to the surface. Put on your own mask first and let people around you know if you are not okay, if you need help. Because our collective well-being is what's going to get us through the storm. The one that's only starting now. The fallout from the months of staying at home and learning to know ourselves and those around us. Now is the time to find our commonalities, not our differences. It's time to get into the fresh air. Yes, to party. We're all looking forward to a good party. But not only that. It's to find out that we have more in common and to draw strength from that. I believe it is the isolation that has brought out the ugly in us. Our racist thoughts were enhanced because we were left to our own perspectives. Our frustration with our family, our women, our children seemed worse than before because there was no respite, there was no diversity. We are meant to operate in communities, to see people that are different from us, to hear different perspectives. It challenges us. It takes us out of our comfort zone. It makes us aware of the light and not just the shadow. So here's to us mending our hearts, our minds, opening our hearts and our hands and our minds to mend not only our broken communities, but also our broken economy. To reach out, to know that there are differences and to know that it's more than okay. It's necessary to have these differences. We can't all have the same perspectives. And I'm speaking particularly to those of you who are struggling to see the good in people or a particular group of people. Make the effort. We are not one of us perfect. So here's to us making an attempt to be kind to other people, to see the commonalities, the things we have in common, rather than the differences.